Hi, I'm Dempsey Pilott, and this week I'm reviewing A Wrinkle in Time was directed by Ava DuVernay, and it's based on a book of the same name by Madeline L'Engle. The film stars Oprah Winfrey, Reese Witherspoon, and Mindy Kaling, as well as newcomer Storm Reid. Now, the film follows a young girl named Meg, played by newcomer Storm Reid, as she searches for her father, who's been missing for a few years now, through space and time. Now, as a kid, I actually read the book myself, and it was actually adapted into a movie in the early 2000s. And as a kid, being so familiar with the source material, I remember just being so blown away by watching that movie. The book itself is actually full of so many interesting ideas that it's so hard not to fall under its spell. So I can see why Ava DuVernay chose this as her next project. And just being familiar with her vision and projects that she's done before, Selma, 13th, I was really eager to check this version of the film out. However, this film didn't quite live up to my expectations. Now, the film itself is not inherently bad. However, it's not the best piece of cinema either. Now, going into this, as I said, I knew the film would be spectacular to look at. Ava DuVernay does a great job directing. The visuals in this film are out of this world. They are phenomenal. I would highly encourage checking this film out in 3D. This film is just so rich with color and beauty, but that's kind of where the awe stops for me, as I said. This film isn't the best film. And it's not because of the actors either. Oprah Winfrey does a really good job, though she does play her part quite peculiarly. And that's saying a lot for a film with lots of peculiar characters. Reese Witherspoon is also really good, and Mindy Kaling as well. But I think the thing that really bothered me about this movie was that the themes were just so glaringly in your face, you know? Now, I'm not going to spoil anything by saying this, but the overarching theme of this film is love. And it's just so in your face from beginning to the very end. And it didn't annoy me, but it didn't really leave much to the imagination of the viewer. When I go see a film, I like to be challenged, I like to think, I like to engage with the film. Films are conversation pieces. So when you have a film that's telling me everything about itself as I'm going along, it takes away from the conversation. And that's what I really think bothered me the most about this film. Now, I saw this film a few days ago and I've been sitting on it for a while, but yeah, like I said, this film didn't really stir anything in me. I guess what I'm trying to say is I appreciate the care in trying to make sure that I got the message of the film, but I think they went a little bit too overboard. Now, that's just my main problem with the film. The film has plenty of flaws. And it's not that I'm gonna nitpick or anything like that. There are just certain times in the movie where it kinda just feels uneven. The movie, it's not a mess, but like I said, sometimes it feels like in the process of taking you on this adventure, it kinda just loses its voice, you know? One of the more major problems that I had with this film was that throughout the film, there were songs playing, and I mean, that's normal for a movie. I mean, sometimes you have the score, and sometimes you have actual songs with lyrics played by artists that show up throughout the movie. Black Panther did it a few times, and this film does it too. The only difference is that Black Panther did it a little bit more tastefully. In this film, there are scenes in the movie where the music appears, and sometimes literally the lyrics are so loud and the music is pumped so loud that you can't even hear what some of the characters are saying. There's this one scene in particular where the music and the sound is just so loud and the characters are actually engaging in dialogue and I couldn't even understand what they were saying. I had to actually like poke my ear out to try and get what they were talking about. And that also really surprised me because I wasn't expecting that. It was an odd choice, really. One other problem that I had with this film is that it's kind of dull. Like I said, it's uneven. At times, it's very exciting and enriching, but it's not a hard story to follow, but the way in which it's executed throughout gets kind of dull. Halfway through the film, there's a scene with Meg, her little brother, and her friend where they're transported to this other place. I don't want to say too much for those of you who aren't familiar to the story. And it's kind of a big deal in the film, but the way it's played out is just like, it happened. And that surprised me. I would have thought that it would have been a bigger thing, but it's just like there are just some points in this film that are made bigger than others. And that, like I said, it seemed like a very odd choice, and that's why I feel like the film came out to be very uneven. One final note. In the novel, there's a character by the name of Calvin. He actually happens to be Meg's friend, and he accompanies her on this journey, like I said, additionally with her little brother. And he is, like, my favorite character in the book. I remember when I first read the book as a kid that he was just my standout character. I really enjoyed what he contributed to the story. And this movie, he's wasted. The actor that plays him, Levi Miller, he's also from the movie Pan that came out a few years ago, he's wasted. Literally wasted. And there are scenes leading up to the climax where he's kind of involved, where he kind of has a role. But ultimately, by the end of it, I realized, like, yeah, he went on this adventure, but he didn't really have anything to do. And that also really kind of got me, like, upset. Because, like I said, he's my favorite character. So I was really interested to see what they were going to do with it in this adaptation. Now, this film is not terrible. It's not the worst film that I've seen, but it does have a lot of flaws. Ava DuVernay's direction is great, as always. The cast is great in this movie. You even have Chris Pine and Gugu Mbatha-Raw, who play Meg's parents. This film has such a star-studded cast, and I think that along the way in telling the story, the film fails because it actually becomes too ambitious. Some things work in this film, but most don't. And for that, I'm gonna give it 2.5 stars.
Oh, wow. Thank you for that.
Thank you so much for watching, guys. I know it's been a while since I posted my last video, but like I said, I really had to sit on this one. Yeah. Thank you so much for watching, guys. And as always, if you like what you saw, hit the like button and subscribe. I'll be putting a link to all my social media at the bottom if you want to follow me on Twitter and see me tweet. If you want to follow me on Instagram and see me Insta, or whatever the past tense of that is. I will also include the link for my Stardust page. Stardust is an app where you can review TV shows and movies. Any movies that I don't review here, I usually review them on Stardust, as well as TV shows. I think there's a TV show that I'm going to review very soon on this channel. But yeah, check out the link below, guys. And thank you so much for watching yet again. And until next time, I'm Dempsey Pilott. Take care.